Hi everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. In Chinese, it is called 補習都可以免費. The English translation of it is Tutorial can be free. The goal of my videos is to help junior high school students to learn mathematics. And if they have any questions, they can ask me in the comment section and I will try my best to answer them accordingly. So in this video, I'll be doing two examples. They are shown here on the whiteboard. Example number one and example number two. For most students, these two examples will show up in a chapter called Algebraic Equation in One Unknown. Some students, when they see these questions, they will feel very challenged because these questions seem to involve a lot of mathematical operations. But I'm going to teach you a simple way to do it. All you need to do is three highlights that I've written here. Highlight number one, two, and three. Highlight number one. The first thing you want to do is to get rid of the brackets as soon as possible. That's the first thing you want to do. Get rid of the brackets. The second thing is like term grouping. So for this chapter, as I've mentioned, it involves only one unknown. So like these two examples, there's only one unknown, which is x as shown here. So the like term grouping involves only grouping the unknown together and then grouped the other things, which should be only the constants together. The third highlight, it involves the equal sign. So in these two examples, you can see there's an equal sign here and an equal sign here. So what you have to do is you have to treat the equal sign as the weighing scale. So whatever you do on the left-hand side of the weighing scale, you have to do the same thing on the right-hand side. Meaning, if you look at these questions, this equal sign here, whatever you do on the left-hand side of the equal sign, you have to do the same on the right-hand side. So these three highlights are very important. So a lot of students will find these kind of questions difficult because they don't know where to start. So that's why I'm giving you these three highlights. Let's work on the highlight one by one. Let's work on highlight number one first. Get rid of the brackets. What does it mean? It means try to get rid of all the brackets as soon as possible. Here you see there's a round bracket. How do you get rid of the round bracket? The simplest thing to do is you just multiply 14 into each of these terms inside the round brackets. Meaning you multiply 14 with x, and you multiply 14 with this minus 10 over 7. So it'll be like this, 10 plus 14 times x, which is 14x, okay? And then plus 14 multiplied by minus 10 over 7. So minus 10 over 7 here, you can treat it as one thing. So that's why we are multiplying 14 with this minus 10 over 7, just like this. So now you want to do some simplification on this thing here. How can you do simplification? Some of the students may know how to simplify this quickly because although I wrote 14 here, it actually means 14 divided by 1, right? So like 14 here is the numerator and 1 is the denominator. So now it's getting obvious how you can simplify this term here. You have a 7 here, so 7 divided by 7 is a 1. And 14 divided by 7 is 2. Okay, so what we have here is 2 times minus 10, which is minus 20. So now we have 10 plus 14x minus 20. Okay, so now we look at the three highlights I mentioned above. First highlight, get rid of the brackets. Do we have any more brackets here? No, we don't. So we move on to the second highlight, like term grouping. So what kind of like terms do we have? We have the unknown term, meaning the terms with x. So we have x over 3 and 14x. This and this are the like terms. In the contrary, we have 10 and minus 20. These are constants. So 10 and minus 20 are like terms. So we want to group them together. So we first group the constant terms first. So now we have 10 minus 20. So these are the like terms. They are the constants. Okay. And then we have the plus 14x here. We'll deal with this plus 14x later, okay? So now, 10 minus 20 is minus 10. And then we have the plus 14x. Although I haven't written anything on the left-hand side of the equal sign, it actually means x divided by 3, as I haven't changed anything. So it actually means x divided by 3, x divided by 3, x divided by 3, x divided by 3. Okay, So now we continue to do our like term grouping. We haven't finished our like term grouping yet because we still have some unknown term, x, on the right hand side of the equal sign. Now we want to group the unknowns together. How do we do that? The simplest way is to minus each side by 14x, meaning it's like this, x divided by 3, and then minus 14x equal minus 10 plus 14x minus 14x. So what we're doing here, this step here, is related to highlight number 3, the weighing scale. The equal sign is like the weighing scale. Whatever you do on one side of the weighing scale, you have to do the same on the other side. So here, the equal sign is the weighing scale. We are subtracting minus 14x on the right-hand side. We have to do the same thing on the left-hand side. So that's why you see I've written minus 14x in red in both sides of the equal sign. Okay, so now we have plus 14x and minus 14x. So that's great because we can cancel them out. Okay, so now we don't have any more x related term on the right hand side of the equal sign. And all of the terms related to the unknown x is on the left hand side. So this is the like term grouping. We're grouping the unknowns and we're grouping the constants. Okay, so now what we're left with is x divided by 3 minus 14x equals minus 10. So now how should we deal with this x divided by 3 minus 14x? We have to do the common denominator. We have to find the common denominator of this term and this term. But you may ask me, this 14x here, it doesn't have any denominator. You're partially right, but in fact, if you think carefully, this minus 14x is actually minus 14x divided by 1. So it does have a denominator, but the denominator is a 1. So now we have a denominator of 3 and a denominator of 1. How do we find the common denominator? We have to know the LCM, the least common multiple of 3 and 1. Okay? And the LCM of 3 and 1 is 3. So how can we get the common denominator to be 3? For this guy here, it doesn't matter because it already have a denominator of 3. But this guy, the denominator is still 1. We have to make it 3. So how do we do it? So I'll continue the answering the question here. So we have x divided by 3, okay? And then we have a minus 14x divided by 1 equals minus 10. If I want to make this term, the denominator of this term to be 3, the simplest approach is to multiply 3 divided by 3. By doing so, we're actually having a denominator of 3 now because 1 times 3 is 3. So the next step becomes x divided by 3 minus 14x times 3. So it becomes 14 times 3 times x. So that's 42x. And then divided by 1 times 3, so that's 3, equal to minus 10. So now for these two terms here, they have the common denominator now, which is 3. So I can do this. 3x minus 42x equals minus 10. Okay, so now which highlight number should we use here? We want to get rid of the 3. The simplest thing to do is multiply each side by 3. By multiplying each side by 3, I can cancel this 3 out with this 3. So now what we are left with is x minus 41x. So that's minus 41x equals minus 10 times 3. So that's minus 30. Okay? Now I want to get rid of this minus 41, right? Because we want to solve for x. We want to know the value of x. So that's why we want to get rid of this minus 41. The easiest thing to do is to multiply 1 divided by minus 41. 1 minus 41. Okay? So minus 41 divided by minus 41, so they cancel each other out. Okay, and this minus divided by minus number, so they cancel each other out. So the answer is x equals 30 over 41, and that's your answer. If you are unsure whether this answer is correct, there's actually one way to verify it. Of course, it depends on whether your teacher allows you to use a calculator. If you are allowed to, you can just plug in this number, 30 divided by 41, to the left-hand side of this equal sign. So you plug in 30 divided by 41 and divided by 3, you record that number. And then you look at the right-hand side of the equal sign. You plug in 30 divided by 41 here, and you compute this. And then you record the result. Then you compare the result that you get earlier from the left-hand side and the answer from the right-hand side. If they are equal, then you're sure that your x equals 30 divided by 41 is the correct answer. Okay, now we're back. Let's take a look at question number two. So I've written number two here, the question here. So now let's take a look at my highlights. The first highlight, get rid of the brackets. So how many brackets do we have? We have this square bracket, and we also have this round brackets. So let's deal with each bracket at a time. Let's deal with the round brackets first. How can we get rid of the round brackets? One way to do it is to multiply 1 divided by 3 to each term inside the brackets. So now we do this 1/6, and then 1/3 multiplied by 1 is just 1/3. Okay? And then minus 6x, which is this thing here, and then multiply by 1/3. Like this. And then plus 1/9, close square bracket, equals x divided by 3. Okay? So here, you can see we can do some simple simplification here. 3 divided by 3 is 1. 6 divided by 3 is 2. Okay? So what we're left with here is minus 2x times 1, which is actually 2x. So it becomes 1/6, 1/3 minus 2x plus 1/9. Because we don't have any more round bracket here, so let's switch the square bracket to round bracket. To round bracket. Like this. Equals x divided by 3. Okay? So now, what's our next step? We look at our three highlights. The first highlight, get rid of the brackets. Have we get rid of all the brackets yet? No, not yet. We still have the round bracket here. So let's get rid of it by multiplying 1/6 to each term inside this round bracket. So 1/6 times 1/3 minus 2x times 1/6 plus 1/6 times 1/9 equals x divided by 3. Okay, so 1/6 divided by 1/3, it becomes 1 divided by 18. So it's 1 over 18 minus, and 2x divided by 6, we can do some simplification here. 2 divided by 2 is 1, 6 divided by 2 is 3. So this becomes x divided by 3 plus 1 over 6 times 9 is 54 equals x divided by 3. Okay, so now do we have any more brackets? No, we don't have any more brackets. Next thing we want to do, group the like terms. So meaning, we want to group the x together and the constant together. Okay, so we basically want to get rid of this x divided by 3 here. How can we do that? We just add x divided by 3 plus x divided by 3. Remember, the equal sign is like the weighing scale. Whatever we do on the left-hand side, we want to do it on the right-hand side. So now, because we have x divided by 3 minus x divided by 3, they cancel each other out. Okay? So what we are left with is 1 divided by 18 plus 1 divided by 54 equals. So now we have x divided by 3 plus x divided by 3. Note that both terms here, they have the common denominator of 3. So we can just do this immediately. Denominator becomes 3, and numerator is x plus x. Now we have taken care of Highlight number one, get rid of all the brackets, so we don't have any brackets here. The second highlight, like term grouping. So we have done that. We have all the constants on the left-hand side of the equal sign, and we have all the unknowns on the right-hand side of the equal sign. So now what? Now we have to take care of this, because we have one term with 18 in the denominator and another term with 54 in the denominator. So we need to do the common, we need to find the common denominator of 18 and 54. So it takes a little bit of experience, but it shouldn't be too hard to spot that the LCM of 18 and 54 is just 54, okay? So how do we get this term, the denominator of this term, to become 54? We multiply it by 3, so we do this. Okay, so we multiply the numerator by 3 and the denominator by 3 as well. So now the denominator becomes 54. So I'll continue to answer the question here. So 3 times 18 becomes 54. And the numerator is 3 times 1. And then plus 1 over 54 equals x plus x divided by 3. This becomes 2x divided by 3. So the next step, what is the next step? Now we have two terms here on the left-hand side of the equal sign, both terms with denominator 54. So we can just do this. 54, 3 plus 1 equals 2x divided by 3. And 3 plus 1 is 4 over 54 equals 2x divided by 3. So we're getting very close to the answer, because eventually we want the answer to look something like this, x equals something, right? So we have something similar, but we still have to get rid of the 2 and the 3 here. So what should it be? What should we do? We multiply it by 3 over 2. And remember, highlight number 3. Whatever we do on one side of the equal sign, we have to do the same on the other side. So we multiply it by 3 over 2. Okay? So with this 3 and 3, we cancel them out. Cancel this and this 2 and this 2 out. Okay? Now we do some simplification on the left-hand side of the equal sign. So what can we do? 2 divided by 2 is 1. 4 divided by 2 is 2. Okay? 3 divided by 3 is 1. 54 divided by 3 is 18. 2 divided by 2 is 1. 18 divided by 2 is 9. Okay? So now we have 1, 9 equals to x. But we shouldn't keep our answer like this. We want the unknown to be on the left-hand side of the equal sign as the answer. So we just write this x equals 1, 9. And that's your answer. So if you like both examples, please subscribe to my channel. And if you have subscribed already, please remember to click on the notification bell icon so that you'll be notified whenever I upload a new video to YouTube. Okay? If you think your friends or even your parents would like to know how to do these examples, you can share my video to them as well. Okay? Thanks very much. See you next time. Bye.